गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, योर हाफ ईयरली एग्जाम इज ओवर नाउ एंड आई होप यू ऑल हैव डन वेल. ओके, यू मस्ट ऑल्सो ट्राई टू डू बेटर इन द नेक्स्ट एग्जाम द नेक्स्ट टाइम. सो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ इट इज़ द टाइम टू कंसंट्रेट ऑन second unit test. So let us see what is the syllabus for second unit test. See, there are two chapters for second unit test. First one is chapter 17, means of communication, and the second one is chapter 25, art and architect, architecture, art and architecture. Okay, so two chapters are there. First one is chapter 17, means of communication, and chapter 25, that is art and architecture. So we will start with chapter 17, means of communication. Okay, means of communication means the exchange of ideas, thoughts and feelings with others. Okay, for example you type your name. Your name is XYZ, and send it to computer, will transform it into a code message, and which will be sent the receiver. Okay, and it will decode it, the receiver will decode it, and that will read again as my name is XYZ. The instrument which creates codes and decodes is called, that is called modem. Okay, so the communication means exchange of ideas, thoughts and feelings with others. So students, communication from your book, communication is a process whereby information is enclosed in a package and is communication is a process whereby information is enclosed in a package and is channeled and imparted by the sender to receiver. Okay, via some medium. There is a medium through which sender is sending his message to receiver. The receiver then decode the message and give the sender the feedback. This is the thing I have explained you. Next is, simply speaking, communication means sharing of ideas in common and communication system, which refers to the channels by which exchange of idea, informations, news and views take place between different individuals groups and institutions. Okay, so I think you have understood what is the means of communication. What is communication, or what is means of communication? This is the thing I have explained to you. Now, we communicate in various way. Today we send and receive messages through email, through mail, you say telephone, mobile phone, radio, then television, fax, internet, all this. But not long ago, what was there to send messages? There were pigeons, or a pigeons, then a horse rider, then runners was used to deliver messages. Okay, now we should know through which the mediums of sending messages: post and telegraphs. Okay, post and telegraphs. Before, high rated telephone calls and mobile, okay, there was most common and cheapest means for the communication, sending and receiving messages is through post office. We can buy postcards in land letters, then envelopes and stamps, okay, and that is from post office, and that is also called postal stationery. These things are called postal stationery. And the speed post is the fastest means of that time. The speed post is the fastest means of sending letters through mail. Okay, so money can also be sent through post office. Air mail is used for sending and receiving letters and to and from abroad. Air mails is used for sending and receiving letters to or from abroad, from foreign countries. Letters and parcels are carried by trains, buses, aeroplanes, helicopter, ships. Okay, thus they take a few days to reach their destination. If the message is urgent, then we send a telegram from the post office. We had to send from the post office. What? Telegram. That time, before mobile and high paid telephone calls. Okay, because they reach faster than letters. Okay, so students, these are all about post and telegraphs. Nowadays, telecommunication is very important, very common, very, very fast. Okay, fastest medium for sending and receiving messages. And now it is being cheaper now. The communication by telephone is called telecommunication. The communication by telephone is called telecommunication. A telephone serves as the quickest means of communication to send messages. We can even talk to a person living in a foreign countries, in abroad. Okay, so do you know about STD, IST? What is the full form of STD? That is subscribers trunk dialing. IST, international subscriber dialing. These are the full form for STD and IST. That is also given in your book. And IST is meant for the abroad, calling people abroad. And STD is you can talk to other people, to other states, people of other states through STD, and local calls are there. So these are about telecommunication. Now mass communication. For telecommunication, landforms work with the help of telephone cables. Landforms work with the help of telephone cables. Pagers, it runs on air signals. Pager. Pager runs with the air signals. But it is one-way communication. So pager is one-way communication service. Okay, the signals are received by a handset, that is pagers. For mass communication, what are the examples for mass communication? Radio, then television, films, okay, newspaper, magazines, etc. are the medium, are the mass communication. Okay. So students, these are called mass media also. These are those means of communication which are used for communicating with large number of people at time. Large number of people at the same time. Okay? So it is called mass communication. Mass means a large number of people involved. While television alone is meant for telecasting. Television alone is meant for telecasting. Now IT. What is IT? The full form of IT is information technology. Students, you will learn the abbreviation and its full form also. So, information technology refers to the information flow through computers. You are also learning in school computer, the subject computer, in class standard 9-10, it will turn to IT, information technology. IT has revolutionized communication all over the world. Okay, information technology includes the following means of communication. लाइक मोबाइल फोन्स, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मिल्स, सैटेलाइट फोन्स, ओके, दैट इज वीएसटी सर्विस, ऑल दिस आर कम्स इन टर्म ऑफ आईटी, इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज व्हाट फॉर टुडे. टुमारो वी विल लर्न अबाउट आईटी. ओके, सो यू रिवाइज what I have told you, what I have explained to you today from your textbook. So the class ends here. Goodbye.